There's something happening to me. There's something awakening in my mind. I can't control it.
Everybody take their seats, please, because it's time for the first June Classroom. Series of videos leading up to the June movie premiering in December, I will each week teach you something about the world of June. You will learn everything about the book, about the writer, the legacy, and of course we dive in deep to everything about the upcoming movie. Each lesson, we will end with a little quiz where we will find out how strong your awareness has been during this video leading up to the final.
You mean how woke we are?
Well, you could say that, but in June terms, I would say testing your awareness, but that's what you're going to learn all about.
I'll write it down.
Yes, write it down. We have to have pencils and notebooks ready, because everything I say in this video will be important for the end of the video when we're going to do this test. And at the end of this course, which ends just before June is in cinema, we have the real big Gom Jabbar test, which will determine who will live in great pain and who will win this quiz.
Sounds nice.
Yes, exactly. So grab your pencils. For the people watching, subscribe to our channel so you're always on time and get ready for our first June classroom.
Fear is the mind killer.
Koen, you're joining this class virtually from Romania.
Yes.
Welcome, Koen. Sven, you're attending this course from the Netherlands, from the city of Amsterdam. Good to have you both here in the classroom, the virtual classroom. To get a sense of your current June level, as a teacher, I have to know that, of course, a bit. what do you know about June so far, Sven?
It's written with a D instead of a J.
Because your daughter is called June River J.
Exactly, in the month. It's directed by Villeneuve, Denise. It has to do, the story is about several worlds. The story takes part at several worlds, and one world is without water.
And
water is really precious.
Okay, good basic level, I would say. Good basic level. Koen, what did you know upfront about June?
It's really, really bad. I saw the other movie, half of it, and I didn't know that it was a planet without water, and it was
shit. I already told me half of the class.
Exactly. So Sven already skipped the first lesson. Very good from Sven. I know, Villeneuve, of course. I know there is a very big war going on between, I thought it was between several families, I think it was, or clans. I know there are huge, worms, I don't know how you call this in the movie itself, but huge kind of worm-looking creatures that are in the sand. And what I remember from the movie was that the main character, he can actually control them, ride them.
Mm-hmm.
Not sure if that's correct, but that was what I saw in the other movie. They use some kind of device for their nose because they cannot breathe maybe on this planet otherwise, or...
I'm going to tell you all about it. Yeah. That's also quite some things that you already know about it, but I still hear a lot of things that I didn't hear yet.
Yeah. No.
So let's dive into it right away with this first class of June classroom.
Where the fear is gone, only I will remain.
There we go, the first lesson. Okay, so what is this story actually about? That's what I'm going to tell you in this first class, without giving real spoilers away for the people that want to stay spoiler free. Of course, there will be some minor story details, more or less the world, what it's all about. But for the people that haven't read the book yet, you will learn a bit about how it all works here. So as said in my intro, pay good attention and make notes, because some of these things that I tell you today might end up in the test at the end of this video, but also in the test at the end of this course. So write down.
Okay.
So here we go. It's of course all started with the novel. The novel June was published in 1965 and is written by Frank Herbert. The novel was originally published as two separate serials in Analog Magazine. Here we see Frank Herbert. It was published in Analog Magazine. And in 1965, it got published the way we know the novel now. In a later lesson, I will tell you a bit more about the writing process and the writer himself. But let's now dive into what this story is actually about. So June is set in the far future, and humans have spread out and colonized planets throughout the universe. The planets of its universe are divided amongst noble families who are in turn ruled over by the Padishah Emperor. The focus of the story is the noble Atreides family, and in particular their young son Paul Atreides, in this movie played by Timothy Chalamet. We see him here to my right. The novel starts with House Atreides living on their planet Caladan. Atreides, yes.
The Atreides family rules over the planet Caladan.
The Atreides family rules over the planet Caladan. Yep. So this is here you can see the planet Caladan. It's a very lush, lush planet, much of green and water. But they get the message that they are granted sovereignty over the desert planet of Arrakis, also nicknamed June. Here we can see June. So the planet Arrakis, the nickname of this planet is June. Well, you guessed it, why it has this nickname. As you can see also here to the right, there's a lot of sand on this planet. Though mostly inhospitable, Arrakis is extremely valuable because it's the only source for a highly valuable spice called melange that can enhance people's mental abilities and make things like interstellar travel possible, amongst a lot of other things that can be done with this valuable spice. And it's the only planet where they have this spice in the galaxy. So that's why this planet is very important. Where Arrakis offers plenty of spice, it lacks water. Sven, you already referred to it. It lacks water. Water is one of the most scarce things on this planet. And since it's so scarce, its inhabitants, the Fremen, wear the so-called steel suits. The steel suits are designed to preserve the body moisture through sweating and urination, and then filter it so that drinkable water is circulated to catch pockets and can be drank from a tube attached to the neck.
My God.
So those are the steel suits. So in this novel, at the beginning of the novel, before Paul and his family leave for Arrakis, he has to undergo the Gom-Jabbar test by the Bene Gesserit, as we could see very prominently featured in the trailer. The Bene Gesserit are a powerful and ancient order of women that try to attain power and influence in their striving to direct humanity along a path of insight and stability. So they have their own political motivations and look to acquire more power. This is also why Lady Jessica, who's part of this group and Paul's mother, is installed at House Atreides. But much of the population mistrusts the Bene Gesserit and calls them witches because of their strange abilities. So to get back at the Gom-Jabbar, the test that we see here and that we saw prominently in the trailer, this was a test to determine whether Paul's awareness is stronger than his instincts. The Gom-Jabbar is the needle that we saw held to Paul's neck. You can see it here to the right. And it's a metacyanide poisoned needle. His hand is then placed in the box, which we could also see. Here we see the Bene Gesserit. But his hand is placed in this box, and this causes him to feel a great deal of pain. If his awareness of the Gom-Jabbar's presence at his neck is strong enough, it will override his instincts to withdraw from the test, which usually involves in a great physical pain. So the test is to not remove his hand, because that will make sure that the needle will touch his neck. So that's the test. It's the test of his awareness. Bless you, Sven.
Bless you. Thank you.
It's all possible here in the classroom, no problem. Yeah. So not long after the test, here we see the test, but not long after this test, Duke Leto...
Mouth cap now, or...?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Coronavirus warning here. Well, that's good. Joke, that's good why it's a virtual classroom.
Bad joke, sorry.
Exactly, but not long after this test, we see Duke Leto, this is Paul's father in the movie, and he's played by Oscar Isaac. And his family, including his concubine Jessica, who I talked about before, who is part of the Bene Gesserit.
What is that? His concubine?
Yeah, concubine. So he's not married. She's more or less assigned to okay. him, okay. so to say. So she's played by Rebecca Ferguson. So they are together with Paul. They are ready to leave for Arrakis. But before they leave, they already suspect a trap being set up for them by their rivals, the Harkonnens, who are led by Baron Harkonnen, played by Stellan Skarsgård. But despite the suspicion of a trap, they decide to go anyway. Well, I don't want to spoil much more of what happens afterwards, because then we really get into specific plot points. But this is more or less the basic setup of the first book. So it's very much about the son of Duke Leto, the young Paul Atreides. As events takes place on Arrakis, we see him develop into the man that he ultimately will become. So this is very much his first story is about him. The story in the first book takes place more or less over the course of 2 years, and it's sort of a coming of age story for Paul. And you can also see it as a classic hero journey, which you can compare with those of, for example, Luke Skywalker in Star Wars. Though Denis Villeneuve compared his character, the character of Paul, his character arc mostly to that of Michael Corleone in The Godfather. So it's maybe not the classic hero journey, but it's based on a lot of those kind of stories. Then we see here the cover of the novel. The novel is a very dense and complex science fiction novel, and it is regarded as, well, maybe the best and most influential science fiction novel of all time. Cool. Yeah, Herbert created this very rich and complex world, and a very important element of his world building is his attention to detail when it comes to the physical environments and how these can have an immense influence on human culture. What's especially very remarkable about this is that Dune focuses much more on the future development of the human mind than on technological changes, which was especially back then very unusual, because it was always about like how does the future look like when it comes to technology. Over time, that changed a bit, but Dune was quite new with that, for that matter. We do see technology, of course, in Dune, like spaceships and that kind of things, but it is especially thinking machines, like computers, that have been banned from the universe after the Butlerian Jihad, when machines try to take over humans.
Butlerian Jihad, that sounds good.
Yeah, that sounds a bit like...
Butler Jihad, what's it called?
Butlerian Jihad.
And also the main planet is called Irakian. It's like, and it's a desert, it sounds like Iraq and a Jihad, you know? Like, what is it going to?
Iraq as well, that's actually interesting that you say that, because a lot of the elements and names in this book are based on the Arabic language and those kind of things. Cool. It draws a lot from the Arabic language, and especially for Arrakis.
Okay.
So that was an influence indeed.
So, but you said the Balearian Jihad, they made sure that it was a ban on all computers, all thinking devices.
Exactly, yeah, all thinking devices. So there is technology, but no thinking devices. This function is being taken over by the Mentats. And the Mentats are more or less superhuman computers that can do the same function. And if I remember correctly, this is also evoked by the Mélange, the spies. So this is very important for all kinds of abilities. Herbert has said that Paul's personage was inspired by the legend of King Arthur, and that the scarcity of water on Arrakis was a metaphor of oil as well as air and water, and for shortages of resources caused by overpopulation. This was very much, and we will get into that also when I'm going to talk more about the writer and his inspirations for the story, but this is also very much about his complaints about what we're doing to the Earth already back in 1965. So there's a lot of influence for that. Mm-hmm. Then one last thing before we end this lecture, that it is good to know that the whole story of this first novel will be told, not the whole story of this first novel will be told in the upcoming movie, because Villeneuve has decided to adapt only half, or maybe a bit more than half, of this book and save the rest for a potential second movie. And the reason for this is what I already said, that it is such a dense movie or novel, so that's hard to all put it in one movie. That's something
but,
you did.
But to say, because this is there are two books also, no, or not?
Yeah, there's more books. I think actually, if I'm correct, he wrote five books.
Okay.
But well, this one, the June one, the first one became the real classic. The other ones are also, of course, very popular, but it was especially the first one that gained his popularity. And then afterwards, his son started taking over, and he's still writing books now together with another writer. So the universe keeps going.
The five books that Frank Herbert wrote, they are also like one, they follow each other, or?
Yes, but I don't want to give too much away about, because the story is going into another direction, so to say, where it comes to where the emphasis is placed, if to phrase it like that. But it is a continuous story, yes.
No, but I mean, like, can we also expect that maybe if it really works, the first movie, that they make more than two, even, you think?
Oh, definitely. Definitely. Yeah. That's why I have very high hopes for this movie, and I think that
maybe
this
like
can.
New Star Wars, then.
Yes, exactly. Because there's a lot of source material. Cool. They actually already announced that there will also be a series on HBO, which is a prequel to the movie, and also Denis Villeneuve is also part of this series.
Okay, cool.
If this movie becomes a hit, I'm pretty sure they're gonna start making this into a franchise. Yeah, I have no doubt about that.
Okay. Cool. Interesting.
So that was more or less. What's also interesting to say is that they are trying on this planet to make it more or less a lush planet again, to get water back on the planet and to make it green again. And so that's something they try to establish, the Fremen, the original people living there. A little extra thing to say. That was my first lecture of June Classroom, the story. Are there any questions for this moment before we go to the test?
For me, no.
No? Otherwise, we just go.
All these names I heard, I just wrote them phonetic.
Of course.
The next time, it would be easier if you display maybe the names you use.
That's possible, yeah, exactly. About, yeah.
Like the planets and the name of the families and all the character names, that would be
yes. We'll do that. Maybe I will do that in the edit, actually.
Cool.
For right. For people watching. Yeah. Not cool. Of help for you now, but when it comes to the test, I won't look at the spelling for that matter. If I get what you mean,
I hope you get it, because I think both me and Sven are like, I don't know even how to spell some things. Yeah.
Exactly. But well, we're gonna see. Let's get this started now. The Gong, okay. Jabbar, test.
The test is simple. Remove your hand from the box and you die.
Then it's time now for the Gong Jabbar test. In this test, we're gonna test your awareness during this lecture. Could you endure the pain of taking in all the information, or did you retreat and find your final destiny in the Gong Jabbar? We're gonna test it now, guys. Grab your phones.
Yeah, do I need to watch also this screen of recording?
Yes, because I'm going to send you photos, but the photos will end up in your app, so you don't have to watch the screen per se. You can also see it on your phone, of course.
Yes, okay. I will use WhatsApp web.
Yes. All right, so I'm going to send you five photos. With each photo, I got a question. You will send your answer in the group. The one who is quickest to answer the question correct earns a point. Yeah, there we go again, Sven. The one that answers most correct wins and avoids the Gong Jabbar. The other one is food for the spice worms.
Nice. Nice. Sounds tasty.
Here we go. Okay. I'm going to send you the first photo. Here it comes.
I don't see anything.
Here it is. I have it. What is the name of the suit that this guy, played by Javier Bardem, is wearing that is designed to preserve the body moisture? I got from Koen.
My God.
Yeah, come on, man.
I got a steel suit from Koen. That's correct.
That was the only thing you know, so the rest is for me.
1 point.
I didn't even look at my notes. Come on, imagine.
I didn't even look at my notes. you look at my notes again, huh?
Class.
We are the best.
Class. Silent, please, class.
Sorry.
Okay, here comes the next one. What is the name of this character played by Oscar Isaac? Koen already has it.
I hope I'm right.
Yeah, you had to be careful, of course. But,
I don't know. It was phonetic.
You put a J.
It was phonetic. I would have said it's good, Sven, but Koen was earlier. But Koen, you have to be careful because your reflexes are maybe sometimes too quick because you don't know for sure yet what my question will be sometimes.
Exactly. I was listening to
the name of the character and I was like, bam.
Yeah. Know? Okay. Okay.
Yeah, but it could also be the name of the actor.
Yeah.
Oh, I heard he said the name of the care and a bum, I put it.
All right, we go to the third question. 2 points for Koen now.
Yeah.
Here it comes. What is the name of the powerful and ancient order of women?
All these names.
I have written ladies called witches.
wrong?
No, that's the name of the mom, but...
Yeah.
Oh.
The name of the group, Sven, if you know it, so tell me.
Jewish family, no.
Jewish family. That would have been really funny.
Benny Jarvis. You're coming closer.
Jarvis?
No. Yeah, well, that's phonetic.
Nee, it's niet, this is not phonetic. I give you a health point for the Benny. Because it was the Benny Gesserit, and the Jarvis is not phonetic.
I give that point, exactly, because I really didn't know. So very
exactly,
good.
Health okay. Point.
So then Gesserit, I'm sorry, these names you have to write down when you explain them.
Gesserit. So,
he said it's Gesserit?
Gesserit.
I think Benny Jarvis is 1 point then, come on.
Okay, well,
that's fair, because it's hard to remember exactly how to write it and whatever in the moment. I think it's fair.
That's sportsmanship from Koen. So then we go to the score 2-1. All right, all right. I count it all right.
Thank you, Koen.
He knew it. Did you write it down or you remembered it?
We are going down further. Next photo here. What is the name of the house of House Atreides, its enemy? And Koen has the point, Harkonnens. The correct word is Harkonnens. And you pronounce it Harkonnens.
Can you write it on the app to see how it
is?
Ah, I thought it was the name of the character, Baron Harkonnen.
Exactly. He is called Baron Harkonnen, but he's also of house. You write it like I wrote it now, the Harkonnens. And you pronounce it as Harkonnens.
It's a bit like
okay, so the name of the villain is called
House Harkonnen.
And the guy who's living there, like the villain, is Baron.
Baron Harkonnen.
Okay.
And his name is Baron, or he is the Baron, or they.
He is Baron Harkonnen. I guess that is his title because you also have Duke Leto.
Oh yeah, exactly.
So they're just with royalty kind of names. Then we go to the last one. The last one comes now. What is the official name of the spice that can be found on Arrakis?
Yeah, I have it. I have to look it up.
Without the
Koen was quicker.
Yeah, I have too many notes.
Yeah, Melange was correct. Yeah. So Koen wins this first, but it's okay, Sven, because this is just more or less
it's
like
your. It's okay. This is
your test. This is the final exam. Is it at the end of this course in December? Okay. But okay, this first round goes to Koen with 4-1.
Yes.
Very well done, my student.
Hello, Duke.
We will feed Sven to the spice worms.
No.
All right, guys. So, did you learn something today?
Yes.
Definitely. Yeah. I didn't know at all these things, but I'm most interested in the Balerian Jihad. That sounded really interesting.
Yeah.
I
found it really interesting that he, in the 60s, wrote about future development of the human mind instead of the technological part. I found it really fascinating.
Yeah, and we will dig into it a bit more next week about where the writer comes from, because he also has been a lot into, like, if I am correct, Zen Buddhism and those kind of things. So he was getting practiced himself with those kind of things. So you can see that has an influence, I think, on this on this story, the state of mind that he was in himself. But that's something we're going to dig in more in the next June classroom, because then we're going to talk about Frank Herbert, the writer, where he draws his inspiration from, how the writing process went. Because what's interesting, a little teaser for next week, this, like you hear about a lot of books like Harry Potter, this book was first rejected by 20 publishing agents until it, in the end, got accepted by a printing house better known for publishing auto repair manuals. So,
no, wow, what a story.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So, and here we are. There's being, I don't know how many million movie made out of it.
But was it also a success when he was still like alive?
Yeah.
Okay, so he enjoyed the very
yeah.
And so, Analog Magazine is a magazine for science fiction, or
yeah, exactly. Okay. Yeah. So yeah, that was it. It was the first June classroom. Next week we're back with the writer Frank Herbert. We're going to talk all about that. If you want to be in time for our class, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. If you liked our class, give it a thumbs up, and well, discuss with us in the comments, because we'd like to discuss about this stuff with you.
Let me know your scores.
Yeah. And let me know the scores, yeah. Well, if it's real June fans, I guess it's 5 out of 5, because it's not the hardest ones for the real June fans. But if it's like people that are not so known yet with it yet, yeah, then it could be a bit hard. This was it, guys. Don't forget, fear is the mind killer, so keep your fear away, and see you next time.
Peace. Bye-bye.
Bye. Ha ha ha.